Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us. As you know, our studio audience is all raring and ready to go, divided into three sections. I hope you are, too. First of all, let's meet our players today, shall we? Got some good ones. On my left, the blue section will have its money on the man. I say the man because he's got the show you all know and love. It's the biggest, I guess, and the best. Mr. Monty Hall and his wife, Marilyn. Well, they're ready to root for you, too. Marilyn, can you hear your section out there okay? Can we hear Marilyn a little louder? Are you there?
I can.
Oh, we've got you. Okay. The blue section is really raring to go, too. They're really rooting for you, and it's nice to have you both with us first time. Next to them, next to Marilyn and Monty, the yellow section has its money on kind of our resident crazy people here. Mr. Bobby Van and his wife, Elaine Joyce. You look terrific today. Both of you look lovely too, Elaine.
I'm a little worried. The yellow section rooted for Monty. I don't know what's going on here. Why don't you sit over there?
No, we don't need you. You have to understand. You see, the yellow section is our traditional banana section.
Right.
They go bananas at the slightest provocation, you know. Thank you.
You like this sweater?
I love that sweater. Let me see. What is that, alpaca?
Oh, what are you doing to my sweater?
It stretches like a rubber band, doesn't it?
Yes. Jesus.
Next to Elaine and Bobby, the red section will be rooting today for Funny Man. Don't you love that for an introduction? Comedy writer Donald Ross and his wife, Patti Deutsch.
Just set him up.
It's nice to have you back, Donald.
The last time I saw you was when we did this show.
That's right.
We have to stop meeting like this.
Yeah, we do, don't we? Now, Patti, how are you, my dear?
Oh, Bert, it's so cold in this little box.
It is.
It's just freezing.
Oh, would you go through your hands on that?
Is Patti in here?
Yeah, Patty's in there.
You mean I didn't get Elaine?
No, you got Patti. I'm sorry, you get the lady you came in with. All right, if you're all ready to go, I'm ready to go. Let's start with our first question, shall we? It's right here. Now, remember, each question is worth $150. I have $150 in the pot. If one of you gets it right, you get the whole $150. The rest of the time, we'll share it among you. My card is totally blank.
Uh-huh.
What's wrong here?
I can answer that.
Oh, inside. There it is. Okay, girls.
Yes.
This is for you now. They say that everybody feels a certain amount of panic during their wedding ceremony and feels like backing out.
Uh-huh.
Now, during your wedding ceremony, when the big question was asked, which of you was the more likely to have replied, "I don't"? Think about that. Don't give us any indication. Everybody panics during the wedding ceremony and sometimes thinks maybe they shouldn't have gotten into it. During your wedding ceremony, which of the two of you was more likely to have replied, "I don't"? Or as Desi Arnaz would say, "I don't." Okay, ladies, go on back there. We'll get back to you in just a moment for your answer. Thank you. Monty.
Bert, that's a terrible question.
I know that.
There's no way of answering it without causing trouble later on.
Right.
I mean, if I say it's me, she'll say, "Why you?" And if I say it was her, she says, "How could you say a thing like that about me?"
Now you got the idea of our whole show, Monty.
You are just going to put an end to a 26-year-old marriage.
That's why it's called Tattletales. 26 years, folks. He ought to know how to play this game, huh? I think you have somewhat of an advantage in years, so let's see how you do.
I would say that she would say
uh-huh, that's right.
That she was more likely to have backed out.
Really, huh?
Only because I'm older than she is.
Or she knows something that we don't know.
Well, and I looked around till I found her.
I see. All right. So you're going to say that
Marilyn was at the ripe old age of 19.
You think she'll say that she was the one most likely to say, "I don't"? Okay. Let's bring her on. Marilyn,
Yes. Now
the two of you are at the altar and the ceremony is going on. Which of the two of you do you think was most likely to panic and say, "I don't"?
Well, if you really want to know the truth, I couldn't wait. So he probably would have said, "I don't."
Yes, that's usually about the way it goes here on Tattletales the first time around, darling. That's not what Monty said. He said he would say, he said that you would say you were the one. Want to explain that, Monty, or should we just
no,
let it...
I think I'm in enough trouble now.
Just let it go with that. Thank you, darling. No scar, a score there, I'm sorry. Okay, maybe a scar, but
scars,
not a score.
Scars, yes.
Oh, the yellow section jumped on me right away. Eight people went, scar, scar. Okay, Bobby, what's Elaine going to say?
Well, when we were going to get married, I had a chain her. To,
I beg your pardon?
I had to chain her to my car, oh, get her to a jeweler, get a ring measured. Then I forced her on a plane to Las Vegas. And it was we got married at 2:30 in the morning.
Oh, my.
And she's still saying, I don't. Of course, you must realize she's much older than I am. But,
yes, of course.
Yes.
She's
don't,
the former...
Don't tell her that, though. No, she never wanted to get married. I don't think she still wants to be married to this day. If she could have fainted when the ceremony went on, she would have fainted. But she'd be the one to say, I don't.
Okay.
Absolutely.
You think she'll say it?
Yeah,
she'll say
right
it.
Now she'll say it. I don't.
All right, let's bring her on. Okay, Elaine, there you are. It's during the ceremony now, and the big moment is coming. Who's most likely to say, I don't?
You know, he, did he tell you he cried?
No, he didn't tell us. But now he doesn't have to, because we know.
Oh.
Poor baby.
He did. He's such a romanticist, you know?
Yeah.
But he cried after, because what he went through to get me there, I mean, it was incredible. And naturally, I'm sure he said it would be me that would say
I That's what he said. However, is that not the case, are you saying?
No.
I cried because the ring didn't fit. It
oh,
was
that's
squeezing
what it was.
My hands.
I thought you were going to say because your shoes were too tight. Okay, well, you have a share of the pot, Elaine. Thank you. Okay, Donald, what's Patti going to say?
It couldn't have been me. I was too drunk to speak. I mean, I nodded a lot at the wedding. No, seriously, I think that... it would have had to be me who said, I don't, because Patty's father paid for the wedding, and he'd have killed her if she said, I don't. Because they live
far,
in Pittsburgh and had to fly to New York, and they went to more trouble.
Okay, so, you say, Patty will say you were the most likely to say, I don't.
I was the most likely.
Let's bring her on and find out. Okay, Patty, what's the answer between the two of you? Who would have said, I don't?
I would have to guess Donald.
That's what Donald said. It's a good guess, and you're right. Not only are you right, at this point, Elaine and Bobby and Patty and Donald split the $150. Okay, and we'll be back with a lot more of Tattletales in just a moment. Please come back with us, won't you?